बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वेलकम बैक टू योर एसे राइटिंग एंड प्रेजेंटेशन स्किल्स क्लास। टुडे वी आर बैक अगेन विद आवर लेक्चर नंबर 7, इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ एसेज। सो टू बिगिन विद, वी विल क्विकली रीकैप आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर, दैट वाज योर लेक्चर नंबर 6, एंड वी आर गोइंग टू सी दैट व्हाट वी हैव डन सो फार एंड हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू टेक दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन इन आवर लेक्चर नंबर 7। So in our lecture number 6, we thoroughly talked about that how to develop an outline once you are unearthing your ideas or you are using the pre-writing techniques, that how you can use the pre-writing technique of creating an outline for essay in your while you want to create one essay on your own. So we discussed two types of outlines. First one was the sentence outline and the second one was topic outline. In the 6th lecture, we also talked about the purposes for using the outline, that how you should use this outline thing and how what are the purposes of using this outline in your essay writing skills. Now there is the first purpose that we discussed, that it helps to organize the key ideas in writing an essay or the research paper. So that's kind of a skeleton, or that's kind of a framework that we have discussed in our lecture number 6, that it provides you a skeleton for your essay. So based on that skeleton, you prepare the internal parts of your essay, and you try to create one complete essay. It helps to summarize the key ideas in reading. It also helps you to summarize each and everything that you want to write in your essay, and it also helps you to develop your subtopic. So you are going to decide in which topic you are going to write what stuff and how they are going to be beneficial once you are creating an outline. So with the help of an outline, now we are in a process of creating and making and crafting different essays. So today we are going to talk about that, what are the essay types, and gradually as we will move on, we are going to discuss each essay type one by one, and we are going to thoroughly see that how you can write down one essay on your own. So to begin with, let's quickly discuss that what is an essay, that we have already so many times discussed in our previous lectures as well. Essay is an organized collection of your thoughts on a particular topic. So essay is always about one topic, and that's all about your personal thoughts, your personal recommendations, your personal findings, your personal opinion about any topic. So we call it an organized collection because you are following a writing process in that. This writing process carries your pre-writing, writing and rewriting inventions. So you are going to make sure that there are all the parts which are supposed to be there in your essay that will make your essay a complete essay are there. So as we have also discussed in our previous lecture, that essay is has been derived from the Latin word exire, which means to examine, to dig out, and then to shape down and then create something. So as we have already discussed, that essay is a kind of sculpture which is first available in the raw material, that is your mud. Then you try to give it a shape through following some outline or by using some kind of a pre-writing technique. And then in the end, you try to polish it and give it the final touches as you move on. So essay has usually got the three major parts because that's the organized collection of your personal opinions and your personal thoughts. So it consists of your major introduction, introduction about the topic whatsoever you want to write in. Then it carries the main body that is going to support your introduction or your thesis statement, and in the end you conclude your essay. Now previously we have also mentioned that you are supposed to create an outline, and in the end, once you have gathered all your opinions, all your ideas, and you have created all the outline and topics and subtopics and then their explanations, in the end you are going to write your introduction and conclusion. Why in the end? Because they are going to be the best introduction and the conclusion of your whole thoughts whatsoever you have gathered. Now, as I have said, that just to give you a recap of what writing process is, it has got three steps, as you can very well see in the slide as well. It carries pre-writing, writing and rewriting. So pre-writing involves all the invention techniques of unearthing the ideas that we have discussed in the previous lecture in detail. All the Free writing, note keeping, outlining, brainstorming, clustering, mind mapping, and so on and so forth. So there are so many pre-writing techniques, like keeping a journal and then questioning, then maintaining a diary. And I've also told you and shared with you that how you can ask the full-fledged questions once you want to, you know, get into or want to write something about your essay. Then your writing stage, which involves your drafting, in which you prepare your draft number one, then you try to revise it, and then you edit it, and then you produce your draft number two. And that draft number two is to be shared by someone, maybe your colleague, maybe your peer, maybe your friend, maybe your teacher, maybe your supervisor. And then you are going to see that what are the loopholes. Remember that you have left some space in your essay for the comments of the reader, so that they are going to help you organize it in a better way. And if there are any thoughts that you have missed out, or if there are any loopholes, any information that is to be added in there, you can add it easily after, you know, listening to their feedback towards your essay. Then the rewriting technique, in which you practically type your essay, or maybe you prefer giving the handwritten essay. So in the rewriting technique, that is used basically to find out if you have inserted or labeled everything, that is your references, if references are sticking to the MLA style or APA style, and so on and so forth. So this is how we have discussed the writing process, which is to be followed in every essay that we write. So don't forget to pick up your pen and your register, because now we are good to go. Now to begin with, let's quickly talk about, because we are to discuss the different types of essays that we are going to stick to, and we are going to practice each one of them in detail in every lecture. So first of all, we will discuss that what is an essay. So essays are usually the examination of, or the collection of, different thoughts in an organized way. Now the essays can be humorous as well as they can be serious. Now essays can be written about the serious topics, as well as they can also create the humor. And there is, you know, one thing that is pun on words, that is there, that Shakespeare uses in a language, and through that very pun of words, he tries to, you know, give a very solid and a very genuine kind of a feedback, or a very genuine kind of a message to his audience. So this is what humorous essays are usually like, that they present something in humor, and they try to, you know, give a very in-depth or very important message through that very essay. Then essays don't have a particular length. It depends on the ideas, that how many ideas do you have, that make your essay long and short. Then essays can be formal, and they can also be informal. If you are following all the elements, and if your style, if you are you know, kind of sticking to others' opinion, and you are looking up the information that has been already produced, that becomes your formal essay, that you are sticking to all the language rules and all the essay writing rules, and then you are writing an essay. And essays can be informal. We have already talked about formal and informal writing styles. Where are some differences? Now, if you use abbreviations, jargons, contractions, complexity in your sentences, your essay will become an informal essay. They, whatsoever essay type is there, they can describe your opinions, or can be a synopsis of the expert opinion. Now, essays can either express your personal opinions to the audience, as well as they can, you know, it can be the synopsis of the expert opinion, means that you are going to get help of from the books, and you are going to quote from different references, maybe encyclopedias, maybe dictionaries. That we are going to see that how to do that. I have already discussed with you the MLA style, in which you know that how to insert the name of the author, the last name of the author, whosoever has written the book, and the year in which he has written the book. And this is how you properly quote the references of someone, as to make sure that you are not copying anyone's work that they have done. So what is an essay? Again, writers use essay to describe or define a subject. Now, for example, they want to describe something, they want to describe any place, they want to describe any person, they want to describe any personality. So this is how any abstract term can be defined also. So this is how an essay can be used to define something. Then they can compare related items in the subject. Now, related items can be compared. For example, related items can be the oranges and apples. Now, as you can very well see in the example, oranges and apple, they both are fruits, but we are going to compare both of them, that what are the qualities in the apple and what are the qualities in orange and how they are similar yet how are they different from one another. Then sometimes you write essays to show cause and effect, that what were the reasons or what were the cause of so and so incident and so accident and so natural calamity or something like that, and what were the effects of that. So this is what cause and effect essay, right? We have also mentioned an example here that if you write it, they will read it. So the cause is that if you write it and the effect it, they will read it. So this is how cause and effect essays are there. Then essays can be a narration, a story, a storytelling. For example, your visit to the market, your experience of listening to me, or something like that. So anything that you want to write on, a narration. Like if you narrate that how was your experience of listening to the 32 lectures of essay writing and presentation skills class. So this is how you are going to narrate your story, starting from your lecture number 1 till your lecture number 32, that how was your experience of staying here. And then explain a process essay. How to write an essay. For example, we have thoroughly discussed in our previous lectures that how to write an essay. So essay has got some steps: pre-writing, writing and rewriting. Now if you are defining this process in a form of a paragraph or in the form of an essay, you will define each one of them one by one, and you will move from first step to the second and then from second step to the third. So this will become your process essay. An essay can also deliver an argument, the case against essay questions. For example, in an argument that is being raised to persuade the attention of the audience, this is also one technique of writing an essay. And an essay can be a critique on something, that why that movie was your favorite movie, or why that movie was your least favorite movie, or why this book is my favorite, or why that book is not my favorite. So this is kind of a critique, picking up all the positive and negative aspects of something, and then reasoning that why that thing is not your favorite and why that thing is your favorite. So this is how writers write for different purposes and for different choices. Now let's talk about that, how to write an essay. A successful essay should meet a number of other criteria. Now we are going to discuss that, what are you supposed to do to write an essay. So see point number one. Before starting your essay, think of the main objective that you have or that you set for yourself and keep in mind throughout your writing. Now you have one objective statement that you are supposed to keep in mind, and you are going to go with that objective statement throughout your essay. You are not going to forget about that, what my focus is and what I am leading to. This is what you, in other words, call a parallel structure, that all your ideas are going in one direction. There is one specific goal that you are supposed to achieve while you want to achieve some target and you want to achieve some goal. Now also you are going to make sure that you know what you are writing about. So all your thoughts, as they are going in the parallel direction and they are moving towards something, so you are going to make sure that you know every time you are going to remember that what you are writing about. If you are going to do that, this is going to be very helpful once you are writing an essay. And your all ideas, all your thoughts will go in one direction. There won't be any idea that won't be relevant, that would be irrelevant to your topic, and you are going to enjoy after looking at your essay that what I have written so far. Then try to start each paragraph with the topic sentence. Then try to support that with your supporting details, maybe the factual information or the evidences or the examples, the relevant examples. By putting in the relevant examples, you can make your essay or your you can start your paragraph with your topic sentence. And then write down the closing sentence. That is going to be the clear indication of that the paragraph has been closed, and that is the logical progression from paragraph number one to the next one. Now, do not be afraid to go into the details. If there are more than you have so many ideas to add in one paragraph related to your topic, do not be afraid to add them, because all the supporting details will be in response to, or will be, you know, supporting your topic sentence. Be creative in your writing. Be as creative as you can, because the essay is yours, the topic is yours, and you are going to write it on your own. Do a thorough proofreading after you have completed your essay. So the best thumb rule is that you are going to see your essay and you are going to proof it, proofread it maybe two times, because that's the best practice, and that will help you overcome and, you know, find out the loopholes that you have in your essay. Now, the best technique is, and the best way of doing is, that leave your writing aside for a while, go out, have fun with your friends, and then come back and then reread your paper. That is going to help you see that what were the deficiencies in my paper and what do I have to write it in it again, and then you are going to, you know, do that quickly. Now, the essay types that we are going to discuss today in today's class are right in front of you in the slide. However, we are in the next coming lectures, we are going to discuss each one of them one by one in detail, and we are going to see the examples of each one of them, one by one. So there are many different kinds of essays, and some of them are here, which are the most common ones. As you can very well see, the bullet one says the descriptive essay, which describes something; definition essay, that defines something; compare and contrast essay, that provide you the similarities and the differences between two things; cause and effect essay, what happened and why it happened and what happened afterwards; narrative essay, that tells you a story; argumentative essay, that is kind of a persuasive essay; critical essay, that tells or that presents a critique on something; evaluation essay, that evaluates something; analysis essay, that analyzes something; reflective essay, that is a reflection on something; and expository essay, which expose something to you and which help you, know, dig out something and present it in front of the audience. So these are some essay types that we are going to discuss during the semester, and we are going to make sure that you practice each one of them yourself, so that you have an ample time for your preparation for the final exam, and you do it with your full devotion and with your complete power in the final exam. Now, first of all, we are going to discuss the different headings and with different definitions of all these types, and we are also find out, and we are also going to see some examples through which we can elaborate that what this essay is and how it looks like. To begin with, we are going to begin with the descriptive essay, which provides detail about how something looks, feels, tastes, smells, makes one feel, or it sounds. So, descriptive essay actually describes something. So you are going to describe or provide details of how a person, a place, something looks to you. It can also describe how something, what something is. They can also explore something, and they can also tell that how something happened. So they can also describe that how the function of something, that how something has happened. These essays generally use a lot of sensory details. So that's all about your sensations, because you are describing something. If you are describing, let's say, a personality, or let's say you are describing a place, so that is going to be, you know, all about your sensations. About all about your imagination and all about your feelings, that how do you see that, how do you feel about that. All your senses will be involved: your sense of sight, your sense of taste, your sense of hearing, everything. So this is how this essay is full of imagination, and this essay carries a lot of point by point details. Now, examples of the descriptive essays are a tree in my backyard, that you are defining that very tree that was in your backyard in detail, starting from the roots. Maybe you then discuss about the trunk, then different, you know, branches of that tree, then different leaves. How do they look in the summers? How do they look in winters? And so on and so forth. Does it produce any fruit or anything like that? And how many times do you have to water it? How many times do you have to cut the branches and leaves and all that stuff? So this is how you are going to describe your tree in the backyard. Then the second example is a visit to the children's ward of a hospital. Maybe that wasn't a very pleasant one, or maybe that was the most pleasant one. This is what you are going to explain if you had had any visit to the children's hospital ward. Now let's talk about the second type of essay, that is your definition essay. Definition essay attempts to define a specific term. So in other words, you are trying to, you know, define something in your own words. Maybe sometimes you take examples from dictionary and encyclopedia, and based on those definitions do you establish your own definition of that very object. It could try to pin down the meaning of the specific word or define an abstract concept. Now that can be something of the specific word which already carries a meaning, or it can also try to, you know, define an any abstract concept. Some of the examples of the definition essay are like the meaning of an abstract concept like love. So love is an abstract concept. Different people, they have got different ways of defining love. So if I ask an American to do that, he would do that in a very different way. If I ask like there are, you know, individual differences as well as there are cultural differences while we explain any abstract term. The true meaning and importance of honesty. Now honesty is something, this is also an abstract idea which cannot be defined or which does not carry any definition. Now you have to describe that from different point of views, and you are supposed to, you know, give different evidences and different examples of how do you define honesty. Then how the meaning of family goes deeper than just your blood relatives. Now if you take the word family, sometimes you say, I consider that person as my family member, because, or I have named that person my sister or that person my brother, because they are, you know, kind of very attached to me and they can understand me better. So you have developed your own definition of a family. So this is how a family definition can vary from person to person and from situation to situation. So that's another abstract concept that can be elaborated and that can be discussed in your essay. The next essay type is compare and contrast essay, which discusses the similarities and differences between two things, people, concepts, places, and so on and so forth. So a comparison essay usually discusses the similarities between two things. Comparison means similarities between two things, and a contrast essay discusses the differences. So a comparison and a contrast essay also carries the similarities as well as differences between two things. A compare and contrast essay may discuss the likeness and differences between two places like New York City and Los Angeles. Now you are going to compare and contrast them, try to find out the similarities and differences between the two places, and how do they prove to be similar and how do they prove to be different. The similarities and differences between two religions like Christianity and Islam. So we are going to try to see that what are the similarities between these two religions and what are the differences between these two religions. Then two people like my brother and myself. Now you are going to compare them as well as you are going to contrast them. But the only thing that is to be kept in mind while you are writing a compare and contrast essay, that nothing goes above. If you are comparing and if you are, you know, contrasting two things, nothing is good and nothing is bad. We are not doing only the comparison, or we are not only doing only the contrast. So this is how we try to make sure that these essays only pinpoint the similarities and the differences between two places, between two people, between two things, and so on and so forth. cause and effect essay, that is our next type of essay, which explains why or how something or some event happened and what resulted from the event. So what was the cause of and how the event happened, and what was the effect that what happened afterwards once the event or the incident has happened. A cause essay usually discusses the reason why something happened, and an effect essay discusses what happens after a specific event or circumstance. So this is how cause and effect essay are being explained. Now the example of the cause and effect essay is a volcano erupts and what happens afterwards. So the cause of the volcanic eruption, what are the causes of volcanic eruption, this is what in the essay we are going to trying to find out, and what happens afterward, this is what is going to be, you know, the effect of your essay. The next essay type is narrative essay, which explains, which is kind of, you know, storytelling or story type essay that tells a story. It can also be called a short story. So in other words, if you have had visited in a restaurant in the past or maybe any grocery store, so you are going to, you know, narrate it in your own words. Well, since they are telling you a story, so they are kind of, you know, conversational in style. They converse to the people and they tell about your personal experience about something. Now if you see some examples, there are written that my brothers and my fishing trips. Now you are going to, you know, narrate your stories of how you and your brother are fond of fishing, and when do you go and how do you go and how are your fishing trips and how many fishes do you fish every day and stuff like that. A boring trip to a grocery store, maybe you were not in a mood to go to the grocery store and you were sent there, so that became a very boring trip for you, so you did not enjoy at all. So how you are going to, you know, portray that in your essay. My near death experience at the beach, maybe you were, you know, trying to swim at the beach and you were about to drown, and you had been looking for the rescue, somebody came to give you rescue, and how once you were rescued, you have explained in your essay that how was your near death experience of you know, drowning at the beach. So that was your narrative essay, in which you try to, you know, narrate a story or tell a story. Now let's move to our next essay type, that is argumentative essay, that's also known as persuasive essay. An argumentative essay is the one that attempts to persuade the reader to the writer's point of view. Now you are sending or you are writing those strong arguments in your essay that is going to, you know, grab the attention of your audience or grab the attention of your reader. The writer can either be serious or funny. Now that's up to you, that what style you want to take, what writing style. Either you are going to sound funny in your essay or you are going to sound serious. No matter what, you are, your main aim is to, you know, convince your reader of your point of view. Now, but always try to convince the reader of the validity of his or her opinion, as it is also very well written here, that you try to grab the attention of your audience. You try to convince your audience that how your thoughts are different, or how your essay is appealing, and how your argument is strong enough to persuade the attention. Either that is an information or that is something else. Now, there are some examples of argumentative essay. He or she should use public transportation instead of driving. So a writer will give those strong arguments or those point of views of his that the reader is going to, you know, get convinced with them, and he is going to, they all those points, all the information whatsoever the writer is writing, the reader is going to get appealed, and he is going to everything is going to, you know, appeal to his logic, and he is going to get convinced with that. Then another example is cats are better than dogs. Now you are going to provide all those evidences, all those information which you feel can make cats better than dogs, so that your reader can be or can get convinced by your arguments. The next essay type is critical essay, which analyzes the strengths, the weaknesses, and the methods of someone else's work. Now, someone has written a book and you are trying to write a critique on that. This has become your critical essay. A critical essay can be written about another essay, story, book, poem, movie, or a work of art. So this is how you write a critical essay about something. The examples of critical essay may analyze how Shakespeare presents the character Hamlet in his play Hamlet. Now you are going to critically see that if he was justified to present the character of Hamlet in his novel or not. The strength and weaknesses of the movie Bowl. You also try to, you know, find out the strengths and weaknesses of, that's kind of a critique. Critique is basically, basically talks about the positive and the negative aspects of something. So this is how you are going to see that or define the strengths and the weaknesses of the movie Bowl. The use of colors in Monet's painting Sunflowers. So how would you elaborate that and how would you put your critique on that? That is to analyze the strengths and the weaknesses of some work, some piece of work or the art, piece of art. Then the next essay type is evaluation essay. Each day we face various facts and senses, and to act adequately we need to develop our assessment of them. So we see different things every day, and to develop our personal opinion adequately we need to develop our assessment of them. Writing an evaluation is a good way to size up a certain item, phenomenon, entity, or any other object. For example, you give your evaluation about a vacation spot, that how that vacation spot, maybe, you know, mostly people like going to the hilly areas in summers. So how that very vacation spot is, you are going to critically evaluate that how is that very spot different from, or you are going to see that how you're going to, in other words, you are going to assess that how that spot is different from others and why do people go there. A new restaurant, you are going to critically assess that too, evaluate that too. Or an educational website that you are going to evaluate that how is it useful and how it is, you know, not working well. So this is how you bring out your evaluation of something, your assessment of something, and you provide it to the reader and provide it for the reader's benefits. Then another essay type is reflective essay. In reflective essay, you express your thoughts and emotions about certain events or phenomenon. For example, if you see the examples, a trip to an exotic place, that you are providing or expressing your thoughts and emotions about that very exotic place. A book that you have recently read. So a book whatsoever you have read, you are going to, you know, reflect your personal thoughts and your personal opinions on that. Writing this type of essay is good training to sharpen your critical thinking skills. So if you want to become a critical writer, this kind of essay is going to help you, as well as your ability to develop and express opinions on a particular topic. So this will help you polish your skills of critically your ability of critically commenting on different topics and different places, or let's say different, and express your personal opinions about that very topic. So reflective essay is going to be one kind, as critical essay and argumentative essays are, that how you are going to help yourself polish your language skills. Another essay type is analysis essay. Analysis essay assumes that you break a larger subject into subcategories. Now you are going to analyze the larger subjects into the subcategories. How? Then examine each subcategory to form an opinion about the whole. So that is, you know, moving from the larger ideas to the smaller ones, and then smaller ideas again to develop a new one. Explain how each subcategory is interrelated and come up with your own conclusion. conclusion. This is what you are supposed to do in your personal analysis essay. Now, economic crisis and the rate of unemployment is the one good example of analysis essay in which you are going to analyze the economic crisis and then the rate of employment that is related to the economic crisis in our country. Then replacing school textbooks with laptops, another issue is being raised that why school textbooks should be replaced with the laptops. You are going to critically analyze it and you are going to give your personal opinion on that. Remember that in this kind of essay, you try to divide major categories into the subcategories and then you try to, you know, define each subcategory in such a way that they are going to produce your personal conclusion. The last essay type is your expository essay. They are the pieces of the scholarly writing which describe or examine a process of some kind of, in a comprehensive way. So an expository essay, they try to describe as well as they try to examine. So in other words, they try to expose something to someone. They can analyze a concept, they can describe and explore a written work or an event, they can explain detailed instructions or a description of a method or a procedure. So this is what expository essay is, that they try to, you know, describe or they expose the reality of something. The examples are the influences of culture and environment. So this is one kind of a very general topic. The internet and society. So you are going to see that how you are going to expose the reality of internet into the society. So that was all about the essay types that we are going to discuss in our upcoming lectures. We have discussed thoroughly so many essay types, and there are many more, but these are the most common types that are used by so many writers every day. So how you can make your essay and how you can, you know, add up cohesion and coherence in your essay. This is what we can see now. The introduction and the conclusion, although very important, are all relatively short. Now, if you go back to, or if you remember our previous lecture, we clearly discussed in our previous lecture that how your outline helps your reader, how your outlines is, you know, beneficial for yourself to understand that what you want to write in the middle portion of your essay. Now, everything that you have written in your outline, based on that, you write down your conclusion and your introduction in the end. And those are relatively shorter than whatever you write in your body, that is your middle portion. So they are often relatively short. The bulk of an essay, both in the form and substance, is contained in the main body. Now, every supportive detail, every argument, every idea, every new topic, every thought, every subtopic will be added in your main body. That will make, or that will help the reader understand that what did you introduced in your first paragraph, that was your introduction essay, and how you have concluded that in your conclusion. So this is how, like we discussed in our previous class, that how once you enter an exhibition, that's a big hall, but there is a small entry of that exhibition, and then there is again one small entry of its exit, so that you are not going to, you know, get back from the same door where did you come. Now, if there is no exit door to your exhibition, you'd have to leave from the introduction or the entry door, because there is no exit to that. So make sure that there is a proper entry and there is a proper exit to your exhibition, like there is a proper introduction and then there is a proper conclusion to your essay. Now let's quickly discuss each one of them in detail. The introduction is intended to lead the reader into the topic and clarifies what the essay will specifically deal with. Now, introduction basically takes the reader or prepares the reader mind that what he is going to really read in this essay or what he is going to deal with. Usually it consists of one paragraph, as I have said earlier that it is a very short thing, a very short one to be written. The amount of background information the context requires. So if you are going to, you know, describe something or if you are going to define something, that will definitely need a background to whatever you are going to describe. So your introduction basically carries the history of something or the background of something that is related to the situation or that is contextual. Then introduction will contain a key sentence or if necessary more than one. So there are keywords being introduced in your introduction, or if there are more than ones, you can also write them down there. So that was the thumb rules for the common methods for writing the introduction. Now let's move on to the main body that deals with the major ideas that support the statement. Now we have thoroughly discussed in our previous lecture that how do you make an outline and how do you stick to that and how do you take it along throughout your essay. Now your outline carries your headings, then your subheadings, and then your supporting details. So there are so many ideas that you are supposed to write in different paragraphs, and they are usually going to be, you know, longer in length as compared to the introduction. Then each idea is presented in a separate paragraph. Each idea that is related to the main topic is going to, you know, be described in the different paragraph. Each paragraph will carry your topic sentence, then your middle, that is your supporting details, and then your closing sentence. Now if you take the example of dogs, let's say dogs are of different breeds. The first idea will talk about the dogs are of different breeds. Second idea that about their health, nutrition, then how to take care of them. Now different ideas are coming along, and you are supposed to take different paragraphs for each one of the different idea. Now the main body is developed with supporting ideas in the form of explanations, definitions, or similar, and illustrated with examples. Now they can be explanations, they can be definitions, and they can also be illustrated with the help of examples where they are appropriate and where they are necessary, because irrelevant explanations or irrelevant examples can divert the attention of your reader. Then your conclusion paragraph, which brings the reader back to the purpose of essay and draws all the points together before making a final comment on the result of the discussion. So your conclusion, some kind of, you know, that wraps up the whole or sums up the whole discussion, all the supporting details in one paragraph, and they also leave the room for the reader to develop their own thinking. They do not shun, or they do not, you know, pack up everything for the reader, because readers, they can also have their personal opinions. Now let's try to grab this concept of coherence and cohesion. Ultimately, an essay will show a progression form from a general level down to the specific. Now you have taken one general idea in the introduction, and you are coming down to the specific, that the statement and body, and back up to the general level again, that is your conclusion. So the general idea is to be followed by some specific idea that is being supported or that has been argumentated in your body portion, and then you move back to your general idea again. So there is one introduction, there is one main body that carries a lot of details, a lot of supporting details, and then in the end you have your conclusion that has got the different, again, that has got the general level. The reader will be expecting this, so it gives your essay a sense of completion. So the closing paragraph is a kind of a paragraph which sums up the information in one paragraph, and reader, he or she gets clearly that impression that the thoughts have been completed in this paragraph. In other words, the essay must have a coherence and cohesion. So there should be a logical progression of the ideas moving from one paragraph to the other. All the ideas should be united and they should be related to each other. Now let's see the dictionary definitions of coherence and cohesion to understand them in detail. Coherence means connecting your ideas together in a logical way, depending on the type of essay you are writing. So coherence is something which helps you connect your thoughts or you know join your thoughts together in a logical way, as to you know make sure that one paragraph which is to be followed by the other have got some logical sequence between them. They are talking about one thing. In other words, we say that all your ideas are moving parallel in one direction. Kohayan means using pronouns, conjunctions and these kind of words to tie ideas into in your essay together. So these kind of words which help construct or which help combine your thoughts and ideas into sentences and sometimes into paragraphs and then from paragraphs to paragraphs and then so on and so forth. These kind of conjunctions and pronouns, the use of these kind of words is known as Kohayan. So we have read about two topics in this lecture, that is Kohayan and coherence, which are going to help you if you are going to you know stick to coherence and Kohayan, and throughout your essay all your thoughts will be logical and they would be connected and they would be you know related to each other. So you are going to take your essay in one direction and you are going to go in one direction and all your thoughts and ideas will be going in, will achieve one point. So that is your essay point, and you are going to, you know, get into it and you are going to grab the attention of your audience. So that was all about today. We have talked about the different types of essays. We have also talked about that how to write a good essay, and we have also talked about the two new concepts of Kohayan and coherence, where which can be used in any kind of while writing any kind of an essay to make your essay logically connected to each other. Now in the next lectures we will be thoroughly discussing all the essay types one by one along with the examples, and after this lecture I will give you one quiz, and maybe you are given one assignment. That one we are going to decide that which one to do first. So I hope that you are going to go through all the lectures that we have done so far, and good luck till the next lecture, and I'm going to give you a quiz in the next class. So come prepared, and I'll see you till next time. So till next time, take very good care of yourself. I hope you have enjoyed learning about the different types of essays. In the next lecture, we will discuss the descriptive essay in detail. Till then, take very good care of yourself and have a very pleasant day. Thank you.